Welcome learners. I am Dr. Sandhya Kumar and today I will be talking on the topic of textile finishes. I hope you remember what textile fibers are and how they are used to form yarns and how the yarns are then used to produce fabrics. Once the fabric has been prepared, whether it is done in a power loom or on a hand loom, then the fabrics are very raw and grey, and a certain kind of processing is done before you can use them in your homes. This is what we call finishing a fabric. A finish is anything that is done to a fabric after weaving or knitting to change its appearance, handling, and performance. Here you can see how the fabric looks before it is finished. It is called the unfinished cloth or a grey cloth, and you can see the kind of fabric that is obtained after it has been finished or given a finishing treatment. Now the question arises, why finish a fabric? A finish is given to a fabric to change the appearance or make it more attractive. It is done to enhance the performance of the fabric. It alters the functionality of the fabric so that you can make it either anti-shrink or waterproofed or any other kind of functions that you want the fabric to perform for you. It can give a desirable feel to the fabric. You can have a very soft fabric, it could be a stiff fabric, or it could be velvety to touch. The finish also imparts ease during laundry, during drying, or during ironing. It enhances the durability of the fabric, and it also enhances the ability to weave, knit, or print of the fabric. Now, all these are operations that are done at different times for different purposes, and we will learn more about them as we continue talking about this. Finishes can be of very different kinds, and we can classify these finishes into various kinds. They can be renewable, they can be durable, they can be routine or special. Here in this chart, you can see the different examples of the fabrics that are there, of the finishes that are applied on fabrics. And we will be now talking about each one of these kinds of fabric finishes in detail. The first one that we talk of is a renewable finish. Now, what is renewable? Renewable means something that you can keep on doing over and over again. That means it is a temporary finish. This is a finish that can be given to fabrics regularly at home. It can even be given by your laundry person or by the washerman. A very simple example of this kind of a renewable finish is starching. When you starch a cotton fabric at home, say whether it is a sari or a cotton kurta that you're wearing or a salwar or a jeans kurta pajama set, the easiest way to finish give these fabrics a renewable finish is to give them a starch, and that is very easily done by making a paste of maida or ararot at home and then dipping the garments and spreading them out in the sun. The next kind of renewable finish, the renewable finishes last only till washing or dry cleaning, and as I said earlier, they have to be renewed after every wash. And these, as I also said, these finishes can be applied at home almost after every wash, and these are ironing, starching, or stiffening. Next, we come to a durable finish. The durable finishes are given at the industry level and they make the fabric fine and strong. An example of this is mercerization. The durable finishes stay on the fabric for its entire life. That is why it is called durable. They are not affected by washing or dry cleaning. These finishes cannot be applied at home, and some of these durable finishes are also special finishes, or they can be routine finishes, and they are often resistant to crease. So I hope you can find out the difference between the renewable finishes and the durable finishes. And now we will talk about routine finishes. The routine finishes, also known as basic finishes or the preparatory finishes. They prepare the fabric for special or decorative finishes, and examples of routine finishes are scarring, bleaching and stiffening. A routine finish is applied to all fabrics. It improves the appearance and enhances consumer acceptability. So when the fabric you see is bleached, instead of the grey fabric or the grey cloth that comes from the mill, after it is bleached, we find it is more acceptable. So a routine finish makes the fabric more acceptable to the consumer, and we wish to buy such fabrics from the market. Now we will talk about special finishes. Special, as the name says, are very special. They are applied with a specific purpose in mind, and they generally change the use of the final article. For example, when you go to the market, you will find fabrics which are anti-wrinkle or waterproofed. So when you want to make an umbrella, you use a waterproofed material, or when you want to make a raincoat, you use waterproofed material. Sometimes when we want to make a dress for wearing in the office, which we are going to be wearing from morning to evening, we want it to be anti-wrinkle. So we're looking for finishes, that special finish which makes the material anti-wrinkle, so that we don't have to change the dress or iron it during the day, and it looks fresh throughout the day. Now, special finishes provide extra functionality, and they impart consumer acceptability to the fabric as well. Examples of special finishes are sanforization, mercerization, parchmentization, wash and wear, dyeing and printing. You may have heard of all of these names at some time or the other when you buy fabric from the market, and they all have a specific purpose, a functionality that they impart to the fabric, and they become more acceptable to you as a consumer. Scarring is a finish which makes the fabric clean after thorough washing. It is the process of industrial cleaning. It is done in the industry. It is done according to the nature of the fiber. So scarring done for cotton fabric or cotton fiber, or fabric made out of cotton fibers, will be different from the scarring that is given to the fabric made out of silk. It removes the wax, the starch, the stain, the oil, the dirt, and makes the yarn or the fabric easy to work upon. So it cleans and it makes the fabric easy to work upon. At the same time, it cleans the unfinished or the grey fabric and makes it more useful for further processing like weaving or printing. Now remember, weaving and printing cannot be done with fabric which is very dirty, or it will not take the colors as you want them to appear on the final fabric. So it is very important to first clean the fabric through scarring. And after washing, the fabric becomes smooth, neat and more absorbent to whatever you want to do with the fabric. Here you can see how scarring or cleaning is done to the yarns and the fabrics. Now, when we talk of scarring according to the fabric types, we can see how this is done for the different fabrics. For cotton, we use boiling water, soap or alkaline substances. They are used in a certain proportion to obtain the clean fabric. For silk, it is boiled to remove the gum. The process is called degumming. For wool, the boiled soap solution is used to remove the grease or the oil. For man-made fibers, the fabric obtained from man-made fibers, we use normal washing. Another kind of finish that we do is bleaching. It is a chemical treatment given to fibers, yarns or fabrics to remove paleness or dullness, to make them more white or to dye them in light colors. So when we get the grey cloth, it is actually grey in color. It is not white. So it has a dullness, a pale yellowness to it. If we want to process them further and to give them colors or to print them in colors, we need a very white fabric. And that is why bleaching is a very important finish which is given to the fabrics or the yarns. Bleaching is a chemical treatment given to yarns or fabric to remove paleness or color, as I said, and to make them very white. And the natural fibers usually need more bleaching. For cotton, we use sodium hypochlorite, it is also called Javel water. The protein fibers are bleached by using hydrogen peroxide, and the man-made fibers do not require bleaching. We can make them as white as we want them. The fabrics have to be very carefully bleached, as the bleach are chemicals and they can harm the fabrics if used in high concentration. Another finish that we use generally is stiffening or starching. Starching is done to make the fabric heavier, stiff and crisp. It gives body to the fabric, makes it very smooth and imparts luster to the fabric. Usually stiffening or starching is done after the basic finish and coloring is done to the fabric. The finish of starching is given to cotton, linen, muslin, poplin, cambric and thin silks. These are the fabrics which usually need starching. It can be done, the maida starch or rice water is used to starch cottons, while gum is used to stiffen the silk fabrics. Often when you go to the market, you'll find that inferior fabrics are overstarched to look dense and better. You can see how a starch paste is made, and this can be easily applied onto the fabrics. Let us talk now of calendaring. Calendaring is similar to ironing and also referred to as industrial ironing. It removes wrinkles and makes the fabric smooth and lustrous. The fabric is passed between two rollers in open width, where one roller is metallic and hot and the other roller is padded. Let us see the process of calendaring. You can see there is a metallic roller and there is a padded roller at the bottom, and the fabric is passed between these two rollers, which makes it smooth, lustrous and wrinkle free. The next finish that we talk of is mercerization. It is a treatment to make the fabric strong, lustrous and absorbent. It uses caustic soda, also called sodium hydroxide, and it makes the fabric easy to dye. This is a routine finish for all cottons. Even the sewing thread that you use for sewing different clothes are mercerized, and sometimes mercerized finish is also mentioned on the label of the fabric as well as the threads that you use. Some examples of fabrics that are mercerized, you can see here, they can be cotton saris or they can be different threads, and many basic fabrics are given the mercerization finish. We now talk about sanforization. This is a pre-shrinking treatment given to certain fabrics to prevent further shrinkage after washing. If you remember, sometime back when we used to buy cloth from the market, we had to shrink it before we could make clothes out of it, because if we did not do it, then after stitching the clothes and washing them, they would shrink. So we had a problem. But nowadays, almost all fabrics are given the sanforization finish, which makes them pre-shrunk, so that after using them, it doesn't shrink at all. The sanforized fabrics are labeled as sanforized or anti-shrink or shrink-proof. So this is a finish which has made life easy for you, because your fabrics do not shrink now. Sanforization can also be done at home by soaking the fabric. As I said, you can soak it overnight, squeeze it and then dry it before using it. Another finish that we use on fabrics which gives it a special character is waterproofing. Chemical treatment is given to the fabrics to make them water resistant, so that the water does not pass through and you can use them for special purposes. And this fabric can be used to make raincoats, umbrellas and in tarpaulins. It is also a durable finish. Parchmentization is a finish in which the cotton fabric is treated with a mild acid, resulting in a transparent and stiff fabric. It makes the fabric thin, transparent, light in weight and stiff, and it seems to be heavily starched. But unlike the starched fabric, this stiffness remains intact even after washing. It is a permanent finish, and you can see this kind of a finish in organdi fabric. Here you can see examples of how organdi is used in dresses, and you can see that the shape of the garment remains as it is. So after learning about the finish of parchmentization, I hope you can clearly distinguish between what is starching and what is parchmentization. Now, parchmentization is something that is done by chemicals and it is done at the industrial level. It makes the fabric stiff, and even if you use it many times, the fabric will not lose its stiffness. Whereas in starching, it is a renewable finish, and every time you use the fabric or wash it, after that you have to renew the starching and you do it all over again. So that is the basic difference between these two kind of finishes, although the final outlook or the product that we are getting is a stiff fabric. Another finish that we talk of is wash and wear. Now, wash and wear is a finish that is used to make the fabric wrinkle free. So you use it as long as you want and however you want to use it, but it doesn't wrinkle. The finish treatment completely changes the nature of the fabrics, and it is generally given to cellulosic fibers like cotton, linen, and sometimes to wool also. So these, as I said, are the wash and wear fabrics are best suited. If you can think of examples for uniforms, or when you wear them for garments which need to be worn for the whole day, you don't want them to wrinkle and look fresh the whole day. So that is the kind of fabric you're looking for, which has the wash and wear finish. Since cotton naturally wrinkles, the chemical treatment is required to make the cloth wrinkle resistant or wrinkle free. It is usually done before dyeing, because the wash and wear finish repels dyes. That means it doesn't allow the dye to come onto the fabric. If dyed and stored properly, wash and wear fabrics can be worn without ironing. So this imparts a convenience to the consumer. You can wash them, put them on the hanger to dry, and then use them without ironing. So that is the kind of difference a finish makes to a fabric. You can see what kind of fabrics are being given this finish of wash and wear. Now, we in this talk today, we have talked about why we need to finish fabrics. If you can think and count on your fingers, I have about 8 reasons why we need to finish fabrics. Now, think back on what we have talked about. It imparts attractiveness to the fabric. It improves the performance of the fabric. It alters the functionality of the fabric. You can make a fabric feel as you want it, whether you want it soft, you want it stiff, or you want a velvety touch to the fabric. It becomes easy to launder the fabrics. You can have them drip dry. You can have fabrics which can be ironed easily, don't need ironing, or they dry very easily. And when you impart finish to fabrics, they become very durable. So these are the reasons that I can think of why any grey cloth needs to be finished before it comes to the market. If you have ever seen the cloth which comes from the mills, you would never want to use it to make any garment or dress for yourself. They are dirty, they have oil stains, they are yellowish in color, and they are not dyed. The fabrics that we use today, see the kind of sari that I am wearing today, it has got beautiful colors. This is printed. The blouse that I am wearing, this green color, this has fabric that has been solid dyed. But the fabric that comes from the mills, that cannot be dyed. So we do need essentially some finishes to be given to the fabric before we can make what we want and use them as we want them. We talked of classification of finishes. They can be renewable, which need to be given over and over again after every use or after every wash. They can be durable, those that stay on the fabric irrespective of how you use it. An example is mercerization. The finishes can be routine or they can be special. The routine clean finishes are scarring, bleaching, cleaning, stiffening. They can also be like mercerization, which nowadays is used as a routine finish. Special finishes can give you shrinkage control. They can be wash and wear, they can be dyeing and printing, they can be parchmentization. Dyeing and printing is something which is a very special finish given to the fabrics, and it has many techniques which we will talk about in some other discussion. But these are things that you must remember about the finishes that are given to garments. And when you next go to the market to buy fabrics for yourself, then you should be able to identify from the markings on the fabric what kind of finish the fabric has gone through. Then you must also be able to understand what is your need, why are you buying the fabric, what are you going to use it for, and does the fabric that you are buying have all the finishes which will make it easy for you to use. So I hope all this will help you in selecting the fabric that you want for making the garments that you need, and that you will enjoy your experience in the market after learning about the finishes given to the fabrics. Thank you.